Pharrell Williams, the men's creative director of Louis Vuitton, showcased his latest creations in a fashion presentation that created quite a stir at Hong Kong's famous Victoria Harbor. With 1,200 guests in attendance, Pharrell Williams' second Louis Vuitton show was a huge success. He turned Avenue of Stars in Hong Kong into a catwalk and unveiled the men's pre-fall 2024 line. Hold on to your seats as we take you to this spectacle of a show. This is Luxury Prima. Along with Bernard Arnault's wife, Hélène Mercier-Arnault, celebrities from Hong Kong and throughout Asia were seated in the front row. These included actors Chow Yun-fat and Karina Lam from Hong Kong, Felix, the house ambassador of Stray Kids, and a K-pop star, actors Austin Lin and Jasper Liu from Taiwan, Dylan Wong from China, and Japanese actor Sho Hirano. Drones overhead created shapes in the sky as sand covered the ground. Ukulele musicians performed, and Hawaiian surfers were among the ensemble. When Williams and the models walked the runway in the finale, the excitement peaked. LV at the belly button of Asia. Pharrell's second show served as a statement of the brand's importance to Asia and Hong Kong. Before the show, Piero Beccari, the chairman and CEO of Louis Vuitton, told Vogue Business, "The Hong Kong skyline is in everyone's head, and having the chance to block the Avenue of Stars, which normally has 2 million people passing through every day, for 2 days is not bad. A decision from the heart," was how he described his decision to travel to Hong Kong. Following the reopening of its borders in mainland China in February 2023, Hong Kong is witnessing a surge in luxury. The geographic location of the city presents a benefit. Bangkok, Seoul, Tokyo, Beijing, Shanghai, and Taipei are all reachable in less than 4 hours by plane. The executive said, "Hong Kong is the belly button of Asia." In 2022, the luxury market in Southeast Asia was valued at $14.38 billion. Between 2023 and 2028, growth of 4.16% per year is anticipated. The primary factors driving luxury goods purchases in Southeast Asia are superior product quality, extended product life, and distinctive product attributes. The luxury market in the region is being driven mostly by millennials and Gen Z, who rely heavily on online shopping. Furthermore, the global luxury scene has been eagerly awaiting a revival as the world works to recover from the COVID-19 pandemic, particularly in Hong Kong. According to a report published in August 2023 by London-based market research firm Euromonitor titled World Market for Luxury Goods, Hong Kong has reclaimed its position as the market with the highest per capita expenditure on luxury goods, a title that had previously been held by Switzerland and the United Arab Emirates. The report also notes that luxury jewelry is the market leading the Asia-Pacific region, or APAC, in terms of post-pandemic growth. "It is audacious to stage such a spectacle in the current economic environment, when companies are more inclined to reduce spending," Beccari states. "We accelerate on the bends as usual." The executive, who was appointed in January, is renowned for taking risks. As CEO of Dior, he produced high-end retail experiences in stores, staged live performances during the pandemic, including one in 2022 in front of the Egyptian pyramids, and raised the standard for flagship stores in the luxury sector by reopening the Dior historical flagship. Beccari says that a destination show like this is well worth the money. "Louis Vuitton is the travel brand, so it's imperative to visit and experience other cultures." This is Pharrell Williams' second show for the house in Hong Kong. Catch your video in his debut Paris show, where he rocked the Pont Neuf Bridge with the introduction of his first collection for spring and summer 2024. Pharrell's halo effect. The top luxury brand in the world, Louis Vuitton, is expected to generate sales of 20.62 billion euros or $22 billion in 2022, according to HSBC forecasts. This amounts to approximately 26% of LVMH's overall income. Nonetheless, the home is not immune to the normalization of growth in the larger business. Sales of LVMH's fashion and leather goods segment increased by 9% in the third quarter of 2023. Can the mega brand go any further? With restaurants, beach clubs, an airport lounge, and rumor has it, plans to establish a hotel on Avenue des Champs-Élysées. The house has already branched out into the hospitality industry. We can explore unanticipated areas, Bakari asserts. Louis Vuitton is a brand that transcends its merchandise. It's a cultural structure, made even more significant in light of Pharrell. When asked if Williams's collections had a halo effect on the company before they were even released in stores, Bakari responds, "I think so. There are a lot of people entering the stores and asking for Pharrell's products. There is a lot of anticipation, not only in the US. I don't have numbers, but my feeling is yes." The Black Ambition. In addition to being a philanthropist, fashion designer, entrepreneur, and producer, and a really imaginative recording artist, Pharrell Williams also founded Black Ambition, a nonprofit organization that seeks to reduce the wealth and opportunity gaps through entrepreneurship. Under Williams's direction, the group invests money and resources in fast-growing businesses started by Black and Hispanic founders. Black Ambition is committed to empowering Black and Hispanic entrepreneurs in order to close the wealth and opportunity divide. Since its founding in 2020, the organization has supported over 5,000 founders with vital assistance through its vast virtual training initiatives and events, assisting them in navigating the difficulties of creating profitable enterprises. Black Ambition has so far provided 101 prize winners with tools and financing, as well as mentorship to 750 more entrepreneurs to help them grow their businesses. The finalists have each received a reward of almost $10 million. Forbes, Essence, Bloomberg, and numerous other publications have honored Black Ambition for bringing out significant change. It was also the recipient of the Impact Investing Category's 2021 World Changing Ideas Award from Fast Company.
That's awesome. I think more and more I just try to like take myself out of the forefront because I just want like these Black and Brown ideas to get the shine that they deserve. They're the ones that's really, they're keeping it going just as much as our you know, our crew and staff.
Yeah.
It's really these great ideas.
Yeah. I heard 90 million plus that was, you know, funded out.
Yeah, 92 million.
92 million. Where should that number be by 2030?
I'm crazy. North of a billion.
Speaking to existence, right?
It's too low. Oh, okay. Oh.
North of a billion.
Yeah, absolutely.
I like that number. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought she was saying like, oh, it's too low.
Yeah.
All right, 2-3 billion.
Yeah.
Indeed, Pharrell's innovative spirit has shaped not just fashion, but inspired a movement. Remember to subscribe to stay connected with more stories of creativity, empowerment, and style. Share your thoughts in the comments below. And let's continue to celebrate innovation and empowerment together. Stay inspired and see you in the next video.